100 fans, this is Eric from hollywoodfrodo.com, and we're going to continue the series of looking at the Droid Turbo Motorola phone and some of the features that are also on the Moto X phones. Today we're going to be talking about the Moto X voice control, the Moto voice control. Of course, one of the features that make it really cool is the ability to always be on and always be listening. Even when your screen is off, it's still listening, even though it's using hardly any power. You can wake it with your voice command. So let's do that now. Okay, Turbo. Okay, Turbo. What's up?
Hello, Eric. The time is 4:36 p.m. Nothing much going on right now.
So you see, it came on to him. I was going, now if I had a text message I hadn't checked, or if I hadn't opened my phone, if I had new emails since the last time I opened my phone, then it would tell me what emails I have. It would let me know a text message I had, who those emails were, who the most recent ones were from, to kind of let me know. So that's just one of the voice commands it has. Now, the Moto Voice Command Center is not an entire voice assistant by itself. They didn't try to reinvent the wheel. There's a lot of things that they knew Google Now can already do. And so those things, it transfers over into Google Now. And there's some plus and minuses to that. But first I want to talk about some of the unique things that it can do. You can say good night and good morning, and you can set it up in Moto Actions that puts your phone into night mode, sort of like do not disturb mode for the night, and then when you say good morning, it wakes it up. You can do screenshots. So, okay, Turbo, zap my screen. And there you go, took a screenshot, which is really cool. You can also, there's things you can do. It tries to open the zap app as well, which is to me a useless app, but it does take the screenshot like it should. You can also, there's some on this particular model, because the Turbo is a Verizon phone, you can say change my plan or view my Verizon bill. It'll open up the app to do that. It does handle making phone calls, so okay, Turbo, call Google Voice.
Google Voice on their mobile phone.
Cancel. So it calls, and what's cool is it's still listening while it's getting ready to call, and you can just say cancel without touching anything, which is pretty cool. Another thing that you can do, which I think is pretty awesome, is take a selfie without having to try to fumble with actually pressing any buttons. Okay, Turbo. Okay, Turbo. Take a selfie. So you can see, it took a selfie, didn't have to press any buttons. Really cool feature. You can give it a command to check voicemail. You can also have it post to Facebook, and you can send a WhatsApp message with it, which is fairly unique because a lot of other voice assistants can't do that, but you can send a WhatsApp message with the Moto Assistant. One of the other cool features that it does handle on its own, if you can't find your phone somewhere, you could yell out the phrase, okay, Turbo. Okay, Turbo. Find my phone. And there you go. It'll ping and do that until you find it and stop to help you find your phone. Now, those are almost all the things. There's maybe one or two other things, but that's pretty much most of what the voice assistant handles itself. The other things that it kind of can do, it doesn't actually do itself. It hands off to Google Now because it knows that Google Now can do those things. So, for example, okay, Turbo, remind me later this evening to buy milk.
When do you want to be reminded?
Evening.
Here's your reminder for this evening. Do you want to set it?
Yes.
Setting reminder.
The message reads, "Hey, what time is dinner?"
So, as you can see, ignore that last thing. That was something I did earlier that was messing it up. But you can see it hands it off to Google Now. This is something Google Now obviously can already do. Setting alarms goes to Google Now. Texting goes to Google Now. If you just say you want to send a text, you can ask it, "When's my next meeting?" That goes into Google Now. So there's some good things and some bad things about that. There's no need to reinvent the wheel. Google Now can do that. But as you saw, when you're using the Moto X, it takes your voice input. It waits for a little while after you're done to make sure you're done. Then it sends it over to Google Now. Then Google Now transcribes it, and then it reacts to it. So it is a slight delay versus if you open Google Now directly using a phrase. So that's kind of the downside of it. It depends on the environment. If it's a noisy environment, then it adds even more time because it seems to take the Moto X voice app longer to detect you finish your speech than it does using OK Google directly. So hopefully that will improve with time. One of the features that everybody loves or everybody really admires about the Moto X voice assistant, besides the fact that you can launch it from any screen, even with your phone completely off and not connected to power. It uses very little power to be awake, and you can launch it anytime, anywhere, which is awesome. But the other thing is that you can create your own command. With Google Now, right now, all you can choose is OK Google. But with this, you can manage your launch phrase, so you can choose OK Google Now, which they say is the most reliable. And you saw I was using OK Turbo. If I used OK Droid Turbo, probably I would have had less. There were a couple times when it didn't activate, and maybe that's because I didn't have quite enough words or syllables, and it wants ideally about 5 or 6 syllables. You can do it with as little as you want, but in order for it to really activate the right way, you want to use something that has about that many syllables. So let's do a different one right now just for the fun of it. Let's do the infamous Jarvis one. Okay, Jarvis. Now it'll tell you that strength. It's telling me that's not a very good one because it's not enough syllables. Hey there, Jarvis. Hey there, Jarvis. Hey there, Jarvis. So now it's going to make sure that those phrases match, meaning it will know. And let's show you one other thing that I didn't show you earlier that's kind of cool. You can take a picture hands-free. Besides a selfie, you can do a regular picture. So, okay, Jarvis. Oh, wait, that's not the right phrase, is it? Hey there, Jarvis. Take a picture. Counts down, and it takes a picture. Which, of course, is a picture of my wall, but because I'm in a dark room in the corner. But that's kind of cool. You can take a picture without having to do anything, and it does it pretty quickly, which is pretty awesome. So there are some pretty cool things that it can do. Hey there, Jarvis. And if you click that more button, it shows you all the things you can do. Now, again, not all of these things are things that it handles itself. A lot of them are things that get handed over to Google Now. So overall, it is cool. I love the fact that I can activate it from any screen. It needs to be a little bit improved as far as noisy situations. Again, in noisy situations, Google Now does a better job of knowing when my command phrase is done versus what the Moto X voice does. And especially using Moto for anything that Google Now handles adds an extra anywhere from 5 to maybe 8-ish seconds on to actually having the command executed versus going directly into OK Google Now. But hopefully that's something that'll improve with the next iteration, especially because I know the next version of Android Lollipop is supposed to have the always listening baked into Google Now. So hopefully they'll increase the functionality of this. But it is a cool feature. I'm glad I have it. It definitely gives me more options. And I use an app called Auto Voice, which gives me I can do even more voice commands because Auto Voice hears everything that goes into Google Now and then reacts to it. So that just allows me to create my own voice assistant to do even all kinds of more advanced things that neither Google Now nor Moto Voice do on their own. But it works in conjunction with those. So very cool feature. Another thing that Motorola started and did that no other phone has right now. Future phones, I'm sure, will have that, and with Lollipop, they'll all have the ever-listening Google Now. So that's it for this video. Hopefully, I demonstrated fairly well so you could really see what you can and can't do with Moto Voice. If you have any questions or anything, leave them in the comments below. I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. Check out my channel for all kinds of Android app reviews, lots of cool apps to make the best of your Motorola phone. Also have a task or tutorial series if you really want to get advanced with taking a full control of your phone through automation and all kinds of cool things. And I have a product review playlist that has all kinds of cool electronics and gadgets and home appliances and things like that. Might want to check out that as well. Anyway, that's it until next time. So enjoy your Motorola phone.